Skinnerd. There's one in every. No Stairway, no Skinnerd. Look, the chat's going like crazy. It's a Frantone distortion? No, it's amp distortion. It's the PV. I was thinking about doing like a live stream or a video about how to play like good guitar, and it wouldn't be like how to play the guitar. It would be for like, you know, just all the little things that, like, if you know how to play the guitar, that you can go from like being okay to like really shredding in like a short step just by learning all the little tricks. Like the key to playing the guitar is just being able to play a single note well. If you can play one note well, then you can play the guitar. Just one note. What I do, I use my right hand a lot when I play. So, I mean, if you're just using the pick and picking a note, but I very rarely do that. I tend to do different kinds of right hand technique to pick a note in different ways. So, like, the regular way of playing it, just a downstroke. But if you bring the finger down, so like bring the string down on the fret as you're hitting the string. So here's the finger down while I'm hitting it. Here, just the rings. But if you have your finger on the string, but don't bring it down to the fret until you're ready to strike the note. See, more control. A little bend. And here's what I do, like typical holding the pick like this, right? But a lot of times what I'll do is I'll bring my finger, my index finger, around like that. Does it show? See, I've got my index finger sort of like on the end of the pick. And so I'll do that a lot so that I'll go from this to this. Up pick, pulling it up, but with my finger there to mute the string a little bit, and then I use my nail to hit it again. Palm muting. That's the other thing. Palm muting. I palm mute a lot. But palm muting just means just that. Taking your palm, laying it on the strings, and just using your palm to mute the strings. So, yeah. Ooh. Can't get it too loud. If I get too loud, the neighbors are gonna start bitching and moaning. It's stuff like that, if you want to learn how to play. And, you know, bends. You don't have to do them really fast. You know, you start out slow and bend up to the next note. Playing guitar. Playing more than one note in the solo. bending more than one note. Go into the octave. This is called Wasting Time. This is what I do. No, I'm not taking requests. I'm just goofing off. Not playing hits. Just goofing off. Where's the Franticaster? It's in the other room with all the other guitars. I just wanted to play the 62 today. Yeah, so the 62. Oh, happy with the bar chords. Hand strength. Practice. The secret to bar chords is not to just fight the guitar. I'll show you. Secret to bar chords. The secret to bar chords is mostly cheating it. Most guitar players, when they're playing bar chords, they're not playing the whole chord. A lot of times, you just use two fingers get like the bottom three strings. So I'm really only like the bottom three strings, two fingers. And then just move it down a string and you're getting the next one. So that's C, G. Yeah. And then if you want to get fancy, you can bar these three strings, you know, with your third finger and do the suspended fourth. There's the major. But I tend to like first position. I don't play bar chords very much because I'm not really a rhythm guitar player. So I tend to do first position. My third finger a lot, and I use my pinky a lot. The pinky is the least used, or probably the most neglected, like for chording, because there are so many ways that you can, like, the strong A is one I like. It's basically an A chord, but then I'm fretting the bottom two of the E position bar chord. I'm taking these two and I'm doing that with my pinky and adding it to the A. I think I found out that Alex Lifeson used the strong A a lot. Yeah, bar chords. The secret to chord at bar chords is not use the minimum hand strength. The less you fight the guitar, the better it's going to sound. If you're really hanging on for dear life, you're going to detune the guitar because you're going to bend the strings, you're going to pull on the neck. Just find the minimum hand strength. Just hit the strings without bringing the strings down, and then. Bring just start adding hand strength. The minimum. But again, most guitar players cheat. They're just two strings. Lazy chords. So yeah, the bar chords is practice. Just, you know, hand strength is everything. Elton is saying, do you play guitar much anymore? Nah. Have I played any guitar tonight? Have I played any guitar tonight? Back to the guitar. In the chat and noodling. Oh, say, I guess people were asking about how are my hands. Well, you know, the same as always. It's playing guitar is hard on my hands, but which is why I don't play guitar all day. I don't play for hours on end like I used to. I do noodle. The SG is pretty easy to play. It's a fast guitar. Weird thing about it, though, I thought about doing a video about Agent of E. The Gibson fretboards, the scaling of the Gibson is shorter. It's significantly shorter than the Fenders. So, I mean, I played Fenders most of my life, but the Gibson scales, it's like 3/4 of an inch shorter, which might not seem like a lot, but you know, for muscle memory, if you're not looking at the fretboard, it's quite a big shift in the scale length. So the Gibson, the SGs, Les Pauls, they're much shorter fretboard, but it's the whole scaling, the scale is much shorter. But that, you know, that's one of the reasons that guitar players kind of prefer, the faster guitar players tend to prefer Gibson's, because it is a shorter scale, so you just, there's less time to get from here to there. It's just a little shorter. Talking about the Van Halen, I just saw a thing about him the other day. Am I a Todd Rundgren fan? Well, I mean, the Philly, well, Ambler, he's from Ambler. He's just one of those guys that, you grew up in Philly, you grew up listening to Todd Rundgren, Utopia, Nas, all that stuff, so it's just Hall & Oates, in the 70s, I grew up with the Philly sound, so all those great recordings, you know, the Spinners, the Delphonics, the Stylistics, they're all recorded like, you know, blocks from here, just blocks. How do you find the SG for staying in tune? It's a very thin neck, you know, it's It's wily. If you, it, you know, I don't know. It's I definitely stays in tune better the more you have it in your hands. Just because with a long, thin neck, just having your hand on the neck, you know, it heats up the neck and it'll bend a little bit. Have you ever built a theremin? Well, no, I own a theremin. Dead Milkman, yes, I, of course, a Milkman fan. I know Joe Jack Talcum, he's a friend of mine, so, it's, you know, Philly's a small town, musically. I'm better than the Strat. No, I like the SG, I like the, I like my Fenders. I like my Franocaster. They're different. The Strats and Tellys play very different from the Gibsons. And I've, you know, I've got Ricks. I've got a White Falcon. You know, so they all have different personalities. All my guitars are different. I don't have any two guitars that play the same or feel the same or sound the same. And each one sort of has its own personality. Like the way I play on the SG, I wouldn't play that on other guitars necessarily. So a lot of the personality of the guitars sort of lend to the way that I play them. So the reason I have all these guitars is it suits my mood. So if I feel like playing the Gretsch, it's a different, I don't play the Gretsch like I play my Strats. My surfing Strats, like, you know, the Hepcat Strat, I play that differently than I play my heavier Strats or my 80s Strats. The guitars have sort of personalities of their own, and their sound, their playability, just the feel of the guitar changes the way that I interact with it. Which is the easiest action? Well, the easiest action is my Franocaster 2, which I did with the, I developed my own kind of, relief in the fretboard. I did a video about that a long, long time ago. That's the easiest one to play. I tend not to play it so much because it's the easiest action, but I prefer the sound of other guitars and the feel and the look of other guitars. It's just not my favorite guitar to handle. It's the easiest to play, but it's not my favorite sounding guitar that I have. My Franocaster. It'd be between like the Franocaster and the SG, like two sides of the extreme, as far as favorite sounding guitars. What prior work did it take to build your own guitar? I did a video talking about the Franocaster. I put it together over like 6 weeks, 6 to 8 weeks. Well, the hard part was just letting the lacquer, getting the lacquer to dry all the way, because I had like 20 coats of lacquer on it, but I couldn't really finish the guitar until the lacquer got hard enough but that took a while to get it to set up. All right, so thanks to the patrons too. I don't have little things showing the name, but you know. I know a lot of you in the chat are also patrons, and you know, I really appreciate it, all the patrons. So, all right, I'll see you on the regular YouTube later this week. Bye.
Bob, all these big bowlers around here that I've looked at are the same. Same rock type. Ooh, who pulled over the geophone module? Can't imagine. Okay.
Fly DBA.
Go ahead.
At the bench.